Hello scientists, welcome to Drupal Mat. Today we'll be drawing the SARS-CoV-2 viral entry, which is how coronavirus enters our cells. Thanks to the scientists who suggested this topic, and please leave in the comments what kind of structure you need to learn to draw for your research. They are very good inspirations for me, and they can help the scientists around the world. If you need urgent help, please visit the Drupal Mat helpline. There you can have a one-on-one consultation with me, or you can choose to view the tutorials earlier and to help you to meet the deadlines. So without further ado, let's start to draw the viral entry. So here I already have the virus that I have drawn in the previous tutorial. You can check it out in the card over here. So first we will need to create the lipid bilayer, but this will be a little bit different from the one that we had drawn before. So first let's create a straight line, and I will make it thicker, so that's 6 points. We will need to set up the stroke style into essentially like two strokes overlapping with each other's. I will go to the appearance panel and then add a new stroke. Now, if I change the color of this stroke, then you'll see the stroke color change here. But if I make it a little bit thinner, like 4 points, then you will see that so the stroke that's on top is green and the stroke underneath is gray. This will create that kind of simplified lipid bilayer that we will be using. And this is also a very common form that you see in these graphical abstracts. You'll see how handy this function is when I start to play with the anchor points on the path. You see the entire path is with this lipid bilayer style. We will be using this as the membrane that we use in the viral entry. If you want to create a new path with this style, then you see that if you directly draw a line there, then it doesn't really apply. We need to do something first, so it will stay with the same lipid bilayer style. So let's go to the appearance tab and then uncheck the new art has basic appearance at the drop down menu. And once it is unchecked, when you create a new path, and the lipid bilayer style will remain. This is really nice because then you use the pen tool to draw a new path, and then it will just apply the style on it. Okay, and now once we have this, we are ready to create our viral entry. First, I'll create the cytosol by adding square underneath our membrane. And then first I will need to get rid of this lipid bilayer. It's quite funny because we just make it into auto-applying, but now we need to get rid of it again. So now, yes, okay, now we only have one stroke for our path, and then we can just go to give it a gradient, and we will give it a linear gradient. I'll spin the gradient for 90 degrees, and then I will put the cyan color in, and we will need a lighter one. So let's go to our color guide and then grab this lighter one and put it in the color box. And I will move it to right underneath the membrane. Send it to the back with the shortcut. Now we're ready to create the endocytosis. It's very important that you first select the membrane. By doing that, you will be able to have the membrane style on your path. And then go to the rectangle tool to draw a rectangle. Okay, once you have the rectangle, and then let's grab our ellipse tool to create a circle. Okay, and then you make the circle slightly smaller, and then move it a little bit downward so there's a gap between the rectangle and the circle. Okay, and then we will need to create another smaller rectangle that overlaps the two shapes that we have created. And I will align these two to selection. Okay, once they're aligned, I will select all of them and then go to the Pathfinder tool to unite all these three shapes. Okay, and then let's grab our direct selection tool and select these four anchor points and use the round corner widget to round these corners. And then select the top two anchor points and press delete to delete them and open the path. So now once you stretch the two ends of this membrane, then you can have the endocytosis on the cell surface. Okay, and I will readjust the ending of the membrane so it fits our cytosol. Now we need to take the excessive cytosol out. So let's first draw an ellipse. I will show you two ways to take them out. The first one is a little bit more complicated, which is the opacity mask. The second one, you can just overlay a white shape over it. And you can see at the later part of the video. But here I will show you how to make that part really transparent. So first you need to create these black shapes that's completely covering the part that you want to mask. I will unite these shapes and then I will select both the black shapes and the cytosol, and then I'll go to the appearance tab and use the opacity tab. In there you can find the make mask button, and then when you press on it, then the part of the cytosol will be masked by the black part, and you will no longer see the black shape. And if you want to adjust the mask, you can go to the opacity tab and then click on the mask window. Then you can adjust the mask. So I need to do it here because if you zoom in, then you'll see some of the cytosols are poking out. They're not masked. Okay, once that's fixed, we need to go back to our opacity mask tab and then return to the normal mode. This is very important, so you can continue editing your shapes. Once that's fixed, we can zoom out and we can start working on our virus. So first I will create an arrow that is indicating the virus is going into the coated pit. So first you create a path, and then I'll cancel. So I will remove the fill and I'll make it 2 points wide, and then I'll go to stroke to make an arrow onto. I'll go to stroke to add an arrow onto the path that we have. I use arrow number 2 because that's what I see in the example. And I will scale the arrow down. So here you can scale it down so the head of the arrow is a little bit smaller. I use 75% here. Now we can make a copy of the virus and put it into the coated pit. And I will adjust the arrow a little bit so it does not overlap with the virus. And now I'll create the endosome, and this part I will speed it up because it is the same process as I have shown you throughout the video. So now we're ready to create the membrane fusion between the endosome and the virus. So first let's get our circle ready, and then I'll create a copy of it. And so the size of this copy should be roughly the same size as the virus. And then I will move it to the endosome that we're about to fuse. And then I will select both of these and then go to Pathfinder tool and use minus. So then that's okay, and now your virus has fused with your endosome. Then I'll select these two anchor points and use the round corner widget to round it. And let's add the spike protein onto the fusion. So first I'll make a copy of the virus and then I'll ungroup everything. Then only take the parts that I want to apply onto our fusion. And then move it onto the fusion. Here I'm using a mask tool to cut off the excessive parts of the spike protein. So I'll draw a black circle. Then I'll go to the appearance and opacity tab and mask. Okay, and then I'll copy the genetic materials, which is the RNA plus the protein that's surrounding it, and move it nearby the fusion. So here I will show you the disadvantage about using a mask in this situation, which is when you want to change the shape of your cytosol, and then the mask will be distorted as well. So in this case, when the background is white, then you can just directly apply a white shape underneath the endosome. So here you see that I'm releasing the mask and then change them into the white shape. So you can use both approach, and depending on the style that you want. Here I'm working on the white fill of our fusioned endosome. So I'll just copy the outline of the fusion, then put it back into the fusion vesicle, and then switch the fill to white. Okay, let's add in the last part, which is the DNA, and I have the DNA brush ready here, so I will just directly apply it. If you want to learn how to use the DNA brush, also check the card over here. I have a tutorial to teach you how to make that. And yeah, once that's ready, and then you have the viral entry graphical abstract. I will show you how to draw those receptors in future tutorials, so make sure you subscribe to DrawBioMed and turn on the notification buttons. Also follow me on Instagram so you'll know when these tutorials are out. I wish you a happy DrawBioMed, and I look forward to seeing you in the future videos.